All right, how's everybody feeling? That was boring. How's everybody feeling? My name is Jeremy Green. I'm a choreographer, creative director, and educator. And this is behind the movement, The Live Intensive. Behind the movement was The Live Intensive was birthed to give dancers an inside look on what it takes to actually work in the field that these dancers aspire to be in, and what it takes to create a live production. So that goes from the audition to the choreography, to wardrobe, to staging, to character, and a lot of mental and internal work as well, and what the industry comes with. So these dancers have been here for 7 days, 8 hours a day, and we've been beating them up. But the ending product is beautiful. Their spirits are beautiful, and I'm grateful that they chose to be a part of this program. So, a couple of house rules. One, you can't be quiet. They work too hard for y'all to sit there and look at them. So I need y'all to get up, scream, yell, give them the energy that they need, please. Yes? Second, they will be crossing in the back. They will be coming down these aisles. They will be doing some choreography right here. So you guys could just be mindful not to block any of those pathways for me, okay? Cool? All right, and then three, I'm gonna ask the audience some questions to ask them. So as this is happening, please, you know, get some questions prepared so we can have a little Q&A and a conversation afterwards, all right? Y'all good? You sure?
Yeah.
All right. All right, give it up for BTMA.
She keeps running.
but I start moving cause they all got beans. If he's trying, I don't give a damn, I'm still getting money, I know who I am. He low, he going on my gram. If he's me, he gon' have a fan. He was bigger, they got your head guys. So I live in my past. Like, girl, but I start moving cause they all got beans. If he's trying, I don't give a damn, I'm still getting money, I know who I am. He going on my gram. If he's me, he gon' have a fan. He was bigger, they got your head guys. So I give him my past. And I just fell in love with a gangster. So he put my name in the top. But I don't let him come to the crib. So we get it on what we got. Nowadays I be looking at them cameras. And they heard that I'm up with them bears. Calling my phone, but they know I don't answer. In the hood, I'm like, just that I am. I'm sick as I'm being at once. Not to tell me how much. If he needs to shoot you, my mom, tell my name and I'm not sure I bet you. Tell my man, I'm the girl in the street. Just think about me when he brushing his teeth. He gets sexy, but I leave him on stage. They know what I'm like.
Keep it a stack. Just move on, cause they know I got beans. I don't give a damn, I'm still getting money, I know who I am. Try to be low, you can hit up my gram. If he's money, gon' act like a fan. If you bigger, they got your head gas. So I get in my pack. Why cause they know I got beans. If he chatting, I don't give a damn. I'm still getting money, I know who I am. Tryna be low, he gon' hit up my gram. If he's smart, he gon' act like a fan. If you bigger, they got your head gas. I'm slow, so I get in my pack.
Thank you.
this. Like it wants you. Now that's what we gon' do, what it wants. Gave me one time. I'm gonna say red, 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 on me. Now I'm gonna get
I'm gonna buy my man down.
Being with with them for the last week. I would not be able to do this without my beautiful co-choreographers and staff. And of course, the man with the plan, Mr. Billy Johnson. Opened his doors for us to create this. Everyone, y'all changed my life. And reminds me of my purpose and constantly. So just seeing you guys flourish and thrive and then taking this and then going and working and booking, it's a feeling that's indescribable. And I'm completely grateful, so thank you. So let's ask them some questions. Anybody? I need at least 5. Yeah, I wanna see what they learned this week.
Great job, first of all.
Thank you.
But seeing the young kids here in the front row, what could you all tell them to get to your level?
Don't keep on people.
Honestly, never give up on yourself. Like, no matter what you see, no matter how talented you see other people be, you're just as talented. And always remember that, really. Like, and look at yourself and you're like, I can do that. I can be that. Or I can be myself and be just as great as that.
Like a brother, as a fellow black man, I'm sure you would love to dance. If you want to dance, remember, dance has no gender. As muscular as I look, if he asks me to, I'm gonna. You know what I'm so dance has no gender, because that, if it's your passion, if that's what you want to do, go for it. Don't let nobody, no other man, because that's their insecurity. Don't let them dim your shine.
Hey everybody, you guys did wonderful. I love coming to see this. My question for you guys was, what do you think you gained the most from this experience?
Hi, I'm Malaysia. What I've gained most from this experience was realizing who I am and my confidence through all the struggles, all the tears, all the feeling down. I realized once I leave this room, I am who I am, and I'm a great dancer, and I'm gonna walk in that, and that's what it is. And I came in here first day, I was shy, I was nervous, I was holding back, I was comparing myself, and as the week went on, after I cried and I called my girl Mo back there, and I called other people and just cried to them, I had to realize, like, man, I'm coming in here and I'm just gonna do what it is. And that's what I gain most, is myself, and realizing myself inside the dance community and out. So I gain my confidence, that's what I gain.
I can't see back there. If you do, come right here for me. Come to the light.
Well, first I want to say happy birthday to my sister, Taisha.
Hi, my name is Emma. I'm a personal trainer, and I feel like Jeremy tested my stamina this week. I had to doubt my certification. I was like, baby, I kill myself. But I would say dieting has so much to do with it, because when we had our breaks, like, what you put into your body coming back either slowed us down or like helped us maintain that. But outside of dance, I would just say like cardio, but really dieting. And just like not only use dance as your cardio, but knowing that dancers, we are athletes. So it's not only what we do in the classrooms, but it's what we take home and work on.
Hi, my name is Amira Cole. I also want to add to that too, because yes, working out, definitely. But it's nothing like pushing through a full out dance. So hitting the dance that you know full out, back to back to back to back to back until you feel like you can't do it anymore. So it gets easier each time you do it. That's something that I know I push myself to do even when I don't feel like it. But pushing through even when you feel like you maybe throw up. Once you push past that, you know you won't go back to that.
Yeah, they done gave me the mic again, yeah. Hey y'all, my name is Myra, but they call me Queens because I'm from Jamaica, Queens, New York. Big Queens, never the little. So what I would have to say to keep my stamina up is literally, well, I'm kind of stole my answer because when I shot my hand up, that's what I was going to say. But it's a piggyback off of both of what they said. It's dieting, it's pushing through, it's the most important, one of the most important parts is the rehab afterwards. You have to take care of your body, whether that be the soak, whether that be the stretch, wrap your, last year, this knee, 24/7 wrapped all the time, or else I wouldn't be able to do what I did. And you just have to, like she said, push through when you feel like you're about to throw up. And one thing, when she first said that thing in my head is what Jocinda was telling me all week, mark full out. If you're gonna mark full out so you could feel how far your body can go, so you know when you have to do it full out where your body is gonna go. And I love her for telling me that all week, because I was not doing that. When I finally did, I said, oh, that's the step. Yeah. You have to, everything that 1, 2, and 3 said will get you to be pushed past your stamina. Eat right, work out, because you have to work out on top of dancing. Just don't think you could dance in the studio and that's where it stops. You gotta go to the gym, hit the weights, you gotta do everything you gotta do to keep that body right, because you only got one, you gotta take care of
it. For a TV show. One more? Yeah, can you come up?
Great job, everybody, that was great. I wanna give a shout out to my daughter Nyla back there. I know sometimes a lot of people around you don't think dance is a real job, right? So, how do y'all push past those not so, I won't say negative, but not so favorable comments you may get from family and friends and things of that nature? How do y'all do that?
I'm gonna have some seasoned dancers answer, and then I'm gonna have some rookies answer, okay? Stanley, come down. So Stanley is already a professional dancer. He lives in LA. Did Coachella with Rosalita, Lil Nas X. Has an impressive resume. And he joined us for some training. So go ahead.
I think at the end of the day, they don't pay my bills, right? Dance pays my bills, hip-hop pays my bills. Hip-hop is what paid for me to do this intensive, which is an investment so that I can then get more jobs to pay my bills. I think, it's funny, but I think what a lot of people forget is that this is your life, right? You have to define your life. You have to do what you want to do. You have to do what excites you, right? And when you do what excites you, it won't feel like work, all those things, but at the end of the day, no one has you like you have you, right? You're the one that has to take care of yourself, and you have to manage your responsibilities. So I think once you establish a sense of self that hopefully comes before you start booking the jobs, those comments are very irrelevant because they don't pay my bills. They don't support me. And they can sometimes provide emotional support in the way that family does and the way that friends do. But you take care of yourself at the end of the day with a loving and supportive network. And you just hope to surround yourself with those people that see the vision that you see for yourself. Even and staying away from the people that don't see your vision when you see it for yourself.
Um,
Basically everything that Stanley said, what helped me is I just really looked in on myself and realized why I'm doing it. It's because I love it. Without this art form, without these people by my side, without just me and me in the studio, it's dramatic, but I feel like I have nothing. So I took that and just said, whatever job comes. I put a lot of trust in God, and I said, I love this. I'm gonna be doing this till my knees give out because I want this for myself.
So I actually had a conversation with Jeremy at the beginning of the year. I was working a 9-to-5 that I absolutely hated. And he actually was the one that pushed me and said, Johnny, you could support yourself creatively in dance if you really wanted to. So I feel like what I'm about to say is really just a combination of what Stanley and Maya said, but it starts with you. And if you're the one pushing yourself mentally and physically and emotionally, you can make dance your primary source of income. You can support yourself off of your creative endeavors, but it starts with you. So as much as you want it, you're gonna get it, in my opinion. Because now I haven't worked a regular job. I haven't worked a regular job in like 4 months, and I've been supporting myself just fine. So it starts with you, and as much as you want to put into it, you're gonna get out of it. And if you love it, like she said, then you'll be all right. Kind of like what Stanley said too. Those comments and that energy from those people don't got nothing to do with you paying your bills at the end of the day. So that's my answer.
Can I ask you guys a question? How many of you guys helped some of the students invest in this? Beautiful, they like it. I encourage you to keep doing that. Just because, and I'm not saying you don't, but just because you don't understand it doesn't mean it's not gonna happen. So, art is special. Art looks different. You can't really follow it. You know, you can go to school for dance and all that, but which is great, but art is supposed to heal. It's like medicine. It's supposed to, it's special. It's supposed to touch people. It's supposed to move people. So, you know, these programs help build, not just teach them dance steps, but build them as individuals, build their character, build who they are outside of this room. We touched on a lot of that this week. And that's why I chose that song at the end, Count Me Out. You know, just regardless of what's going on, don't count yourself out. Keep pushing. And one day it's all gonna make sense. So I appreciate you guys for investing in them. I appreciate you guys for trusting me, my team, with your training. We love you, we support you, we're gonna continue to push you. And thank you, BTMA. Oh, one more thank you. Gordy Korea.
Big Gordy.
This guy did all the music. Phenomenal, creative. We appreciate you, brother, always.
Yes, sir. None of this would be possible without Jeremy Green, so please make some noise. This is all his idea. I was in the room when he pitched this idea to Billy in August of 2020, and it's now May of 2023, and it's still building. So this is all to you. We believe in you. Thank you for this. You need to get your flowers.
Thank you. Love y'all. BTM what? Boom. All right, we're gonna take some pictures. Thank you guys for coming, and that's a wrap.